Hello everyone, in this video I'll teach you how to use the Icon Composer to build stunning icons for your Expo application. Let's get started. So what is Icon Composer anyways? Icon Composer is a new tool bundled within Xcode 26 that Apple introduced alongside the iOS 26. With Icon Composer, you design icons as multiple layers, background plus foreground layers that the system combines. This lets you apply effects like translucency, blur, lighting reflections, and shadows to make your icons look like pieces of liquid glass. The Icon Composer supports default, dark, and tinted modes, all within the new .icon file. So before iOS 26, it actually was a bit painful to handle icons natively on iOS, but for Expo apps, we used to use the static PNGs, usually 1024 by 1024. You could manually provide alternatives for dark mode or tinted appearances. But with Xcode 26, that static approach doesn't leverage the new layered system. The .icon file is now the recommended format for icons on Apple platforms. So if you're targeting older iOS versions or Android, I actually made a video a while ago that still applies and it's completely valid. And actually you should watch it to learn how to make icons for Android and even reutilize the same asset for your splash screen. And if you're targeting older iOS versions, that video is going to help you as well. I'm going to leave the link in the description. Okay, so to follow along, you're going to need Xcode 26 or newer, a development build, or a physical iPhone to test the icon. You'll also need your original icon asset, ideally without a background as a PNG or SVG. And if your icon requires multiple layers, you're gonna need all of them. Okay, so now let's jump into Icon Composer. Okay, the first thing that you need to do is open Xcode 26, and then at the top left, you can click on Xcode, and then under Open DevTools, you'll find the new Icon Composer. Okay, so this is how the Icon Composer looks like once you open it for the first time. By default, it comes with this blue color. On the left, you'll find some layers, then the title of the project, and you can also test some backgrounds like this one. By default, it comes with this blue gradient, but you can select automatic, which is going to use white for light mode, dark for dark mode, and then mono for tinted. Okay, so at this point, we are ready to drag and drop our assets. Now, this time, I don't have an asset. So in this case, I'm going to be using a CLI tool that I built that allows you to generate icons, and actually you can use it to generate your icon asset and then drag it to Icon Composer. So if you are interested, you can, it's actually open source, you can just use it by providing your OpenAI API key and then run a command like this one. I'm going to change to warp, and I'm going to run this command npx snapai icon. My prompt is going to be a single line outline of tattoo needle tip. Now you can set flags like background transparent, style minimalism. Let's hit enter. This is going to generate an icon for me. Okay, and my icon is ready after just a couple of seconds, and I can open it. And this is how it looks. Of course, you can play around with the style and the prompt to get different styles. But once you have your main asset, you can just take it and drag it into Icon Composer. Okay, so from here, I'm going to open the location of my icon and drag it inside the Icon Composer. This is how it looks. From here, we can actually do many things, like changing the color of my icon asset or changing the main color of this. For example, a solid color, you can choose a dark color. And if you want, you can also change the color of the icon that we just generated by just going to the right. Then you can select fill, solid, and select a color like orange. Or you can also do a gradient. And then let's do this from orange to blue. This looks really nice. Let me close this because I actually had something before that. I'm going to delete it. And I was playing around with some generations that I created with Snap AI. And I want to show you how this looks, right? So first of all, you can just drag your icon and move it around. You can duplicate the same layer by right-clicking, duplicate, and then, you know, compose something more complex here. Okay, so let me delete this and this. So on the top, you can turn on this grid to make sure that everything is within the safe area of the icon. By default, my CLI tool, SnapAI, is going to generate the right dimensions because it generates a 1024 by 1024 image without a background. So this is how it looks. And of course, you can always change the color. So in this case, I'm using orange, but I could use, I don't know, this one maybe, or purple. And then we can turn this off if you don't want to look at it. At the bottom, you can see how this would look like in dark mode or mono. And if you want, you can actually rotate this to see how this would look as the user moves the device. So this is an option. This looks okay to me. Now let's hide it and let's see the other one. This is actually a really nice one, really minimalistic, that I really like it. Let me turn on the grid. Now in this case, as you notice, it's actually going above. So what we can do is just select the layer and then make it a bit smaller here. And you can actually pinch on your trackpad to zoom in. And then I'm going to move it on the Y axis. Perfect. I'm going to zoom out. Hide the grid. Let's see how this would look like on dark mode and mono. Now, if you want, you can also play around with some backgrounds. In mono, I think this looks better. So for example, if I change the color, this is how it would look like. So it's actually hard to see, and it all depends on the user, right? They might really like this style. Personally, I don't really like it, but you know, some of them look cool. Anyways, I'm going to go back to the default. So at this point, I'm pretty happy with this result. I think I would keep this, but just to show you, you can actually use a complete image for your icon. For example, I generated this one using this prompt, using the style game. So maybe you want to explore something similar. This was my prompt, background transparent. Of course, in this case, it didn't work because I'm using the style game, but this is the result. So of course, you could try to select this and make it smaller, but in this case, this is actually not going to work since this is a static image with a background. But cool thing to know is actually that for mono, this is how it's going to look. So let's see how this would look like with a background. This actually looks pretty cool to me, or this one. And by the way, another very important thing to notice is that in this case, we cannot have like the layer effect, the glass effect that you can turn on and off on the right. So this is not going to do anything. And by default, this is off when you are using a complete image like this one. But yeah, I'm going to hide it. I think this one is easier to see. By the way, I didn't turn this off and on. And it's actually hard to see on video. But this is basically supposed to make it glassy. And as you can see, there is like a small change when you have this on and off. But anyways, let's say that we're happy with this result. If you want, you can actually just export some assets for marketing by going to File and then Export. Then you can select the platform. But I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to go back to the default. From here, I'm going to press Command S to save it, and then I'm going to save it inside my assets in my project. So my project is called AI Tattoo Assets, and then I'm going to call this one Tattoo iOS or something like that and hit enter. And now this is saved. So let's go to my project, and here we have it. So this is the Tattoo iOS.icon file that we generated using the Icon Composer. So you don't really need to worry about what's inside this file. It's basically the assets that Apple created and a JSON file that Xcode is going to use to, you know, handle the different states and designs of the icon. Now let's go to the app.json where we can actually define the icon. And right now at the moment, you can see that I have this not very good icon. So here you can see the app on the right. This is the current icon that I'm using. It's not my favorite, so let's update it. Since Expo is SDK54, you can actually just replace this path to be the path of the .icon file. Inside assets, now the new path is tattoo-ios.icon. It's just inside the assets. And we're getting a small warning, but this actually is going to work because I'm using SDK54. And just to show you, let's see, Expo 54. This is my version. Now, after this change, we need to pre-build our application. In my terminal, I'm going to say npx expo prebuild platform iOS. Let's pass the clean flag. Hit enter. Okay. And just like that, now I have my icon. Okay. And I can turn on dark mode. This is how it looks. Super nice. And then I can also do the customization. So if I go to edit, customize, select clear, clear or tinted. This will actually be fully compatible depending on what the user wants, right? So they can have it dark, auto, and yeah. So overall, I prefer to have it dark with auto, but now my application fully supports all these modes. Now, in case you're wondering how this is going to look for older iOS versions, since the dot icon was introduced only for iOS 26, this is how it looks. I just compiled it for iPhone 16 Pro using iOS 18. And this is how it looks. You can see it here on the right. You cannot test dark mode or tinted mode on the simulator, but it's going to work as well for older versions. So you don't have to worry about it. Now for Android, make sure to check out my other video. I'm going to leave it in the description. And that's it. The main shift is moving from the flat.png icons to a layer.icon file using the icon composer. Now the glass effect is only going to apply for iOS 26 and up. But keep in mind that it's compatible with older versions as well. So it's just one small change that is going to apply to all the versions. So I hope you liked this video. I hope you learned something new. Don't forget to give it a like, leave me a comment, check out Snap AI, make sure to start the repo, and I'll see you in the next one.